Write this engaging and riveting novel. Bill,
yes,
tell
sir.
Me about Stinger. First of all, how'd you come up with the title?
So, you know, we wanted to write a Valley novel, and of course, a Valley novel is going to involve ag.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to involve the dirt, the earth. It's going to involve, you know, very interesting people. And as we're going along, out of real life comes the honeybee collapse disorder. And so we decided, Tanya decided to make that kind of part of the plot. So we have bees in there.
Hmm.
And then there's some revenge involved in this novel. So what's the bee version of revenge? A little sting.
A little sting. Give me the behind the scenes of why you guys wanted to write this book and team up together from the part where it was a thought and now this, the hardcover.
So it was actually a challenge by a mutual friend over a little too much wine at Rutherford Grill in Napa.
Most things develop over
a
glass of wine.
So the challenge was, why don't you two write something together? And Tanya said, I'm a novelist, he's a journalist, it's not gonna happen. But then we went home and it kind of marinated, and 4 or 5 months later, we agreed to do it. And I have to say that I'd already pitched a novel of my own and was going through that process. So we had some pages already and some characters already.
How long did it take you to develop what you have? And are we talking about real life characters here inside the book?
Well, obviously, yeah.
Yeah.
They just have different names.
Fictitious names.
Yeah, and so part of the fun of this is going to be guessing, oh, who is this?
Mm.
And some people will.
You know.
Well, yeah, I know.
But you're not going to say.
Well, no, that would take all the fun out of it, right?
I believe Mark Arax was a part of this as well.
Yeah, he's the publisher for West of the West, and this is the 7th book that's been published by his imprint.
This book, it's pretty much a smorgasbord, if you will, of everything. What was your favorite part about writing
this
book?
Come on, we say a buffet. Let's have a nicer word.
Okay, well, a charcuterie plate. How about that?
Yeah, there you go. Right. So, I mean, my interest, my background, sports, and it's a Valley novel. Sports, especially Friday Night Lights and football, is a big part of that. So we knew that was going to be in it. And also the sports side, opportunity for some humor and, you know, take the novel in a little different direction.
Wednesday, you had a book signing. When you're describing this book to other people and maybe over a glass of wine, what do you say?
Well, what I say is there are a couple scams in here.
Mm-hmm.
And if you grew up watching the Rockford Files, in the novel, it's kind of be like a two-part Rockford Files, you know, where there's a scam and you're saying, does it get carried out or does it get exposed? So you have that going. You know, there's some love there, love scenes in there and love interest. Tanya took care of that, obviously. And then there's just politics. And the central theme, though, is that a giant corporation has taken away the land of a small valley farmer, and as life goes on, their children, having suffered the loss of the farm and everything else, decide that someday they're going to get even.
All right. You can get it on Amazon. You can also get it on Kindle.
Well, it's on Amazon and Kindle form for hardcover. It'll be in Barnes & Noble very soon, and if you really want it, you can give me a call at GV Wire, and I'll make sure it gets delivered right into your hands.
Bill, I appreciate the time, as always.
Thank you.
All right, can't wait to read it, all of it. Still to come, our Tweet of the Week with a little hunka-hunka burning love.